Hello, my name is Twyla Kennedy, and I'm the Lead Economic Development Specialist for the Minnesota District Office. Today is Tuesday, March 24th, and I'm going to do an overview of the Economic Injury Disaster Loan, or EIDL, program. The EIDL is meant to assist businesses as they recover from an economic injury as opposed to recovering from a physical disaster. These are the only loans done by SBA directly. There is no outside lender involvement as the funds, processing, and servicing are all done by SBA. The start of the disaster is January 31, 2020, and my understanding is that we are looking at a 6-month time frame for it. Because you are applying directly to the SBA, there are no fees to apply. Anyone that thinks they may be eligible should apply, but keep in mind, you don't have to take the loan if something changes between when you apply and when you receive approval. To be eligible, you need to be a for-profit small business or a private nonprofit. There have been a lot of questions about startup businesses. It may be more difficult to show your ability to repay without a year of financial statements, but if you are declined, you will have an opportunity for reconsideration and can provide extra documentation to support your position. There have also been some questions about those in the gig economy. In part, your eligibility is going to be based on how you file your taxes. At this point, almost all eligible small businesses are going to qualify. To determine if you are small, visit the website below. Again, keep in mind that SBA will decide on eligibility based on all of the information provided in the application. The loan officers at the Disaster Center are reviewing each loan package on a case-by-case basis to make decisions that will best help small business owners. Nonprofit status can be based on either state or federal tax law. The Disaster Center is encouraging any private nonprofit to apply and let the loan officer make the determination on eligibility. Nonprofits will need to provide tax returns regardless of loan size. These are some of the ineligible businesses. The first bullet point on agricultural enterprises. This would be something that if you grow it, you feed it, or water it, would be considered agricultural and would not be eligible unless it's an agricultural aquaponic business. The second bullet point causes a little confusion because it says charitable nonprofits are not eligible. But if you aren't sure about your status, apply. So these loans will be made in amounts up to $2 million at 3.75 or 2.75% interest, depending on the entity, and can have a term for up to 30 years. This loan is to be used to pay bills that occur in the ordinary course of doing business. My understanding is that the loan officer will determine the amount and term of the loan based on the financial information that you provide in the application process, and we'll be looking at things like your loss of revenue based on the virus. Please note, there are no prepayment penalties, and there will be a 12-month deferment during which time you will not be required to make payments, but interest will be accruing. Criteria for loan approval would be credit history, repayment, and collateral requirements. The SBA will pull a credit report, but don't get hung up on your credit score. The loan officer will be looking at credit history as well as repayment ability. Collateral will be required for loans over $25,000, but generally, lack of collateral will not be the sole reason for declining a borrower. If your financial statements show available collateral, the SBA may ask you to pledge it. Generally, the SBA looks first to real estate and then to other business assets as collateral. The next couple of slides will speak to some of the documentation. These documents can be obtained at the disaster application website that comes up on slide 13. The first item, tax information, tax authorization form, IRS form 4506T, allows the IRS to release your tax information to the SBA. Make sure the information you fill out on this form matches the information that was on your tax returns. For example, if you put Bill on this form and filed as William, the IRS will not provide SBA with information. Special note that income tax returns will not be required on loans under $500,000. The Schedule of Liabilities, SBA Form 2202, is a list of your obligations showing original amount and date, current amount and date, whether the obligation is current or delinquent, the maturity date, the payment authorization, payment amount, and how it is secured. Personal Financial Statement, SBA Form 413, is used to analyze repayment ability and creditworthiness. It includes your assets, liabilities, sources of income, notes payable, stocks and bonds, real estate owned, and a variety of other assets and liabilities. Keep in mind, this form is about your personal finances and not your business finances. Please note that for partnerships, owners with 20% or more in a company, or affiliates, you will also need the tax information, the SBA Form 413, and the IRS Form 4506T. If you have not completed your 2019 tax returns, there are alternate acceptable documents. Additional filing requirements, SBA Form 1368, is used to show economic loss. You'll be listing month-by-month sales figures for the last 3 years and current year to date. This form may be replaced by EIDL Supporting Information Form ODA Form P019. The Disaster Center will let you know if you need to submit these documents. Now you're ready to apply. We have been advised that Edge is the browser of choice for this process and appears to cause the least problems. So the listed Form 5A is the actual application. It is here where you will fill in the specifics of your business, such as name, address, phone number, information type, etc. The second box on that form lists the various types of disasters, and you will want to make sure that you select economic injury, EIDL. This is important because it will get your application kicked out right away if you have the wrong disaster type selected. This form and the previous ones can be printed out in advance so you can see what information you need to have available to complete the process. Please note the fields with a red asterisk are required and you cannot proceed without providing the required information. So your options to apply. The recommended way to apply is via the online portal, but there is a mail-in option for those businesses and areas with connectivity issues. Keep in mind that applying by mail will take longer. The link on bullet point one is the location to apply and access the documents from the previous slides. At the top of that page is a link for loan information, which is where you will find the forms, FAQs, and other useful information. There's a save button on each page, which will allow you to come and go out of the application as necessary. A word of caution, when you're setting up your account, it is very important to record your password. There is no way for SBA to reset your password, so do not lose it. If you do, you will have to start the process over if you exit and try to return to your application. The address in the center of the page is where you will email your paper applications if you choose to provide those. And at bullet point three is the information to contact the customer service people for assistance with any issues. Please note, we have a lot of applications coming in. and we understand that the process is slow. It may help if you go online from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m., which would be off hours, and do your submission. You want your application to be complete and accurate. Printing and pre-filling the documents should help with this. You can request to have your loan increased or decreased after submission. And please note, it is important to request reconsideration for a denial as quickly as possible. You will have two chances to request reconsideration. The loan officer needs to take into consideration your entire package before they can make a determination on the size and term of the loan. So some of the questions that you have cannot be answered until the disaster center has the application. For credit elsewhere, the loan officer will review information provided to determine how much the business needs to pay its ongoing bills and what kind of liquid assets they have. If it appears the business can pay its ongoing bills out of the liquid assets, they may be declined. Again, keep in mind, you can request reconsideration. Personal guarantees will be required regardless of the size of the loan, and they may need to be secured. The determination on that will be done on a case-by-case basis by the loan officer. For error messages, contact the customer service center, and they will be able to look at your application and help problem solve. Minnesota has great SBA resource partners around the state. They can help small business owners prepare and understand their financial statements, as well as provide general business advice. We already know of SBDC and consultants and score counselors who are assisting clients with the application process. Feel free to contact our resource partners and utilize their expertise. If you are not already getting Minnesota District Office's newsletters, the updates listed there, www.sba.gov/updates, is the best way to know what is changing in the process and in the program. Please be sure to sign up for our newsletter. You can also follow us on Twitter. If you have questions at the end, you can send those to the Minneapolis District Office mailbox listed there, or you can send them to the Disaster Office mailbox listed below. A couple of final comments. When you complete the online process, my understanding is that you're going to receive some kind of immediate notification that the application has been uploaded or accepted. The Disaster Loan Center will be processing loans on a first-come, first-served basis. Submit early, but do not be concerned about funds availability. If you have trouble uploading your documents, please keep trying or send them in an email to disastercustomerservice@sba.gov and include your application number. The Disaster Center is trying to complete approvals in 3 weeks, but this is uncharted territory for them, so it may take longer. Thank you for your time, and again, feel free to reach out to us if you have questions.